the amount of times that I have had people say to me, you got a great life, you're succeeding professionally, you got great kids, your wife's awesome, like, what do you have to be depressed about? They do not understand the disease. Nobody has asked for this. Did you ask for your Parkinson's disease? No. You know, it's the same thing with mental illness. In its most severe form, it's a terminal illness. And unfortunately, your entire mind is being wrecked. All the while, you're being judged by society. And the fact that there could be something to save people's lives is just outstanding. My name is Jon Nelson, and I am a deep brain stimulation patient. We're the messy house in the neighborhood with basketballs outside, and we're doing a lot of sports. I love coaching, and I get to do that with my boys with ice hockey. I get to do that with my daughter with softball. I love it. I love it. I am an outgoing guy. I am the guy that nobody expects has this disease. But at the same time, at the peak of my depression, my entire body feels like dying. That's the disease. It's exhausting. Any opportunity I could get to sneak up the stairs and go into the bedroom, I would do it. I was grasping at straws to try to get better. And at that point, I had figured out that there is this deep brain stimulation as an option for clinical trials. And I said, all right, let me see if there's a way that I could get into it. The procedure itself is an 8-hour brain surgery. While most people are scared about that, I didn't care. And I didn't care because I was okay with dying. Until the day before, and we dropped my kids off, and my youngest one looks at me and says, Dad, am I gonna see you again? That was the first time in years that I felt like living. I still had that one little glimmer that kept me here, that I'm here because of my kids. The surgery itself was on August 22nd of 2022. They put two dime-sized holes in my head, and there's two electrodes that go straight down. The cord goes down my head, on the back of my head here, goes down kind of the side of my neck, and then it goes into a pacemaker. It's right here on my chest, and this is constantly going. I have 22.5 million electrical pulses per day to my brain. After the surgery, came home, and I said to my wife and my youngest son, do you want to walk the dog? I initiated it. I enjoyed it. I have not had a single suicidal thought since. Not one. Not one. And it was about 6 weeks in, I started to feel a twinge of feeling depressed. And what I learned is that the procedure made me happy because I'm disease-free. But it did not take away the normal human emotion of sadness. So I needed to learn to live with being sad and how to know that it was gonna pass. I didn't know how to do that because it was so traumatic for me. And I'm still learning. I am proof that major depressive disorder is a brain disease. It's that unfortunately, due to how society handles it and stigmatizes it, keeps people quiet. There needs to be a better understanding of what it is. And the more that that happens in society, the more lives will be saved. I hope to be as big of a patient advocate as I am to being a good dad and a good husband. Like, that to me is what is goal. That's my legacy that I want to have.